Good morning, students. We are going to discuss chemistry in chapter 3, synthetic fibers and plastics. Already ma'am has taught you what is synthetic fibers, what are the types of synthetic fibers, and how are they, what are the properties of them, and how are they used. These are the things ma'am already taught you, and she also taught you how what are plastics, how it is derived, and what are the properties of plastics. And she might have taught you the two types of plastics, that is thermoplastic, thermosetic plastic, and she might have told you about the uses of that. Now we are going to see why plastic is a material of choice. See, why do plastics are widely used? You yourself know that first the word has derived from plasticus, which means it can be molded into any shape. Okay, then so whatever the shape we need, we can make it, and whatever the color we like, we can color it, and it is easy to handle, it is easy to carry because it is lightweight, and they will not react with the substance what they are storing in it. It is leakage proof, air proof. Okay, then many it has long duration, that is durable, and it has a good tensile strength, and it is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. These are the things we are going to discuss today. Okay, now why plastic is a material of choice? Why we are using it? We have seen that what are the characters. In that, particularly we are going to see why the plastics are non-reactive. Okay, see, usually those days the people have used metal buckets, metal utensils like iron, aluminium. But after few days, when it is exposed to air and water, they starts to corrode. If it starts to corrode, the materials will not be as previous. It loses its nature and it will become damaged. Okay, it will become corroded, and that is why we are using plastic. It is non-reactive. They will not corrode. They will not react with the substance what is stored in the vessels, like plastic water bottles, plastic containers, plastic buckets, plastic box, all these things. So they will not corrode. So it will be useful for long duration. And when you see this, it is a non-reactive, already we have seen. And that's why even the chemicals, they will not react. So they are stored in the plastic vats, plastic vessels, plastic apparatus. Okay, then plastic also has a character of being light. They are light in weight. So obviously what? People like to carry it. If it is heavy, we will be feeling very bad to lift it. But if it is very light in weight, what happens? Obviously, people like to carry it. Okay, that's why we use the lunch bag, lunch box. Okay, then water bottles, all these things which are made up of plastic we are using because it is light in weight. Then when you see, it is very strong. What is tensile strength? The fiber content of plastic, okay, it cannot break. It is that much strong. They have high tensile strength. Because of that high tensile strength, it is strong enough, okay. So even heavy weight, you can carry in a plastic containers. Then already we have seen it is long lasting. What is long last? The life duration of the plastic is high. That's why we are using plastic. And it is a poor conductor of heat. Okay, what for it is used then? So the frying pan, okay, the handles of frying pan, it is made up of a backlight, which is one of the plastics that will not conduct heat. Because if the frying pan or the cooker handles, if it is heat, we cannot carry it. So in order to carry it, they have used plastics. They are called backlight. Okay, what is the spelling of backlight? Is B-A-K-E-L-I-T. A backlight is a plastic which will not conduct heat. That's why they are using handles. Even the screwdrivers, tester, no, it is used conduct it will what it will test whether the current flow is there or not. To check the flow of current we use tester, and the screwdriver all these things. It will not conduct electricity, so the handles of tester, okay, and the screwdrivers, all these are made up of plastics. And can you see these are the things that's why they are using and the wire, electric wires, you know, it is covered with plastic PVC, okay, that is also plastic because it acts as an insulator. When the current pass, a cover is insulator, so the current will not pass on our body. That's why in order to safeguard, plastics are used. Not only for these purpose, in medicinal fields, the syringe, the chemicals are stored in the plastics, and the saline, all these things. If you see the instruments, in medical field, it is used wide area in medical field. Not only in medical field, and in micro oven also, we are using plastic. It will not melt, it will not react with the foodstuff, but it will be heated. And then like this, it is used in various fields, okay. That is why we cannot reduce plastic. Now they are asking to reduce the plastic usage, even though it is asked to reduce, but we are not supposed, we are just trying to reduce it, okay. These are the thing I have to discuss, I thought. And we'll be seeing what are biodegradable and non-biodegradable. See, plastic and the environment. There are two types. One is biodegradable. Decomposed into smaller particles, and they will be becoming a nutrition for the environment. So biodegradable are the substances which decompose in the presence of bacteria, or the action of bacteria, the substances are broken down into smaller thing, and it will be a nutrition for the environment. So these will not pollute the environment. Whereas what are non-biodegradable? The substance, even though in the action of bacteria or some bacteria, they will not decompose. It takes even several years, it will not decompose. So it become a pollutant. For example, biodegradable leaves, okay, the food substances, then paper, leaves, trees, all comes under the biodegradable. Then non-biodegradable, what it's obviously, the plastics are non-biodegradable. They will not decompose earlier. And even metals also, it takes more years to decompose. It will not decompose. It takes millions of years, that too they are non-biodegradable. So we have to choose materials, okay, substances which are biodegradable, and you should avoid non-biodegradable substances like plastic, metals, all these things. So we should be aware, and accordingly we have to use the substances. Okay, now we have seen why plastic is a material of choice. What is that? First one is, it is non-reactive, it is light in weight, strong, durable, and then poor conductor of heat and electricity. What are the field it is used and how far it is used, why it is used, we have seen. And the next thing is plastic and the environment, that is the next heading. Under that, biodegradable and non-biodegradable we have seen. Biodegradable means by the action of bacteria, the substances undergo decomposition. That's, those substances are called as biodegradable. Example, food waste, the garbage is of food waste, peel of fruits and vegetables, then paper, wood, all this thing. Non-biodegradable, metals and plastics. Okay. the next class. And examples based on biodegradable and non-biodegradable we can see. And what are the 5 R's we will see in the next session. Okay. How can we avoid? One thing is, instead of using non-biodegradable, we should use biodegradable substances like cotton bag, jute bag, all these things. Okay. Now you came to know why they are used and why they should not be used. That is what we have seen in this session. I hope you can understand and how we are, why we are using plastics. You would please learn these things and worksheets will be given